In cinema, a little allure goes a long way. When it comes to unintentional wardrobe malfunctions, however, the effect can be more humorous than titillating. We're here to show you a handful of our favorite wardrobe flubs. There's something special about the Star Wars film universe's far-reaching, wide-ranging appeal. Though creator George Lucas reportedly owned up to purposely making his prequel installments more friendly to a younger audience, a vast majority of Star Wars fanatics are adults. And apart from an innuendo or two, likely meant to make the older crowd chuckle, the movies have remained largely squeaky clean, with one notable exception. In Return of the Jedi, actress Famie Taylor portrays Ulla. The green-skinned slave dancer Jabba the Hutt holds captive in his palace. Before Ulla meets her grisly death at the mouth of a hungry rancor, Jabba makes her strut about in her skimpy outfit while he watches. When he grabs hold of Ulla's chain during the sequence, he causes a wardrobe malfunction that makes her costume reveal something you'd never think you'd see in a Star Wars movie. The slip happens in the blink of an eye, but it definitely ended up in the movie. The fact that Lucas was a stickler for scrubbing up footage for home releases makes it especially bizarre that this malfunction didn't end up on the cutting room floor. Watchers of Vanilla Sky aren't left wanting additional adrenaline-pumping action, an extra smattering of stirring sci-fi, or more eyebrow-raising decisions that make Tom Cruise's character seem genuinely dangerous. One of the most noteworthy scenes in the film involves such a move made by Cruise's David Ames, who captures Cameron Diaz's Giuliana Gianni, his one-time lover, and straps her to the bed. Diaz, wearing a sheer dress, attempts to flip herself over on the mattress and, in doing so, accidentally shifts the top of the garment out of place. The actress is quick to fix the wardrobe malfunction mid-scene, pulling the gown into its original position, but the chest-exposing take wound up in the film's final cut. Arnold Schwarzenegger has been in the spotlight since his days as one of the world's foremost champion bodybuilders. Over the years, he has starred in a plethora of blockbuster action flicks and, of course, governed the state of California. But even the former governator has suffered an incident on the set, experiencing a wardrobe malfunction countless fans have noticed. During the opening scene of 1984's The Terminator, Arnold Schwarzenegger walks around in his birthday suit before he gets a chance to cover up. Low lighting, clever distant camera angles, and the stereotypically poor quality of the original 1980s footage preserve Schwarzenegger's dignity for the most part, but those naughty bits still made it into the movie. The remastered Blu-ray edition shows the actor stark naked and on full display as he approaches a group of young ruffians.
Hey, I think this guy's a couple cans short of a six-pack.
You're close. Give them to me.
In the 1980s, VHS cassettes were the state-of-the-art form of media distribution, and without an internet, salacious rumors, and news about movies spread via word of mouth. These are the factors that spread the notion that there is a moment of accidental near-nudity in the 1985 horror comedy Teen Wolf. Pause the tape at just the right moment, the rumor said, and viewers would see an extra in a crowd shot with the fly of their pants wide open and the white underwear beneath fully visible. The scene in question is a high school basketball game in which the titular Teen Wolf Scott Howard aggressively competes. The crowd cheers, and a shot of a spectator in the grandstands made it into the final cut of the film, and the zipper of their pants is indeed unzipped. This definitely isn't the most graphic example on this list, but it's nonetheless a solid example of a surprising editing mistake. Considering that Samuel L. Jackson has previously expressed his view that nude scenes are, quote, extremely awkward to film, you'd be right to assume that the prolific actor has never in his decades-long career sauntered around in his birthday suit for a movie. As it happens, however, you'd be wrong. In the 2001 drama pic The Caveman's Valentine, Jackson plays a paranoid schizophrenic man who becomes inextricably involved in a murder mystery. At one point, he strips down and struts past a mirror in a scene likely meant to show off only his buttocks, but as most malfunctions go, a lot more was caught on camera. In a flashbulb moment, while his backside is on display, viewers can see Jackson's front side, too. The Caveman's Valentine never got a Blu-ray release, meaning no one will ever see a high-resolution shot of Jackson's nether regions, so his dignity is at least partly preserved. The 1981 Australian drama war film Gallipoli is noteworthy for a few reasons. It took home a grand total of 8 Australian Film Institute Awards, boomed in the box office down under, earned a Golden Globe nomination for Best Foreign Film in 1982, and fared well with critics. It's also become known for a vastly different reason. Gallipoli features a bit more of Mel Gibson. A then 25-year-old Gibson shows off everything he's got during a scene in which his character, Archie Hamilton, the stockman and sprinter with his sights set on the Australian Imperial Force, sheds his colors to go for a swim with his soldier pals. When he dives down to the seafloor, we end up seeing more of Gibson than we should have. He clearly wasn't given any costume modifications to help prevent any slippage, and the shot wasn't clipped out of the theatrical or home release versions of the film. Bad Boys 2 is a small slice of heaven for any fan of the buddy cop and action comedy genres. It's got a leading duo who work off one another's attitudes and push each other's buttons, a high-stakes mission the pair have to embark on, a seemingly indomitable villain, and the ubiquitous beautiful and badass woman who ends up a love interest for one of the protagonists. Gabrielle Union is that more than a pretty-faced character in the film, so it's unsurprising that she's seen sporting some revealing outfits. One in particular is a little too low-cut, however. In a scene where Union's character chucks a gun toward a live minefield and then ducks for cover, her cutout dress slides sideways to reveal her nipple. In real time, the malfunction is a bit hard to spot, but slow down the footage just a tad, and you'll see Union's chest clear as day. Denzel Washington leads the 1991 crime thriller Ricochet, playing LAPD Detective Lieutenant and Assistant District Attorney Nicholas Stiles. During a locker room scene, an unclothed Washington leaps up from the bench to hide behind a locker door when a woman enters the men-only zone. In this split moment, his manhood gets a fraction of a second of fame. An untrained eye wouldn't be able to zero in on the explicit shot, but if you look just carefully enough, it's definitely there. There Will Be Blood is the story of a greed-driven oil man named Daniel Plainview, fascinatingly portrayed with shocking brutality by Daniel Day-Lewis. The actor received his second of three Best Actor Academy Awards for his work as a driving force of the California oil boom in the late 1800s and early 1900s. Plainview aggressively cajoles and bends rivals and allies alike to his will, traipsing all over others metaphorically when he's not traipsing literally around his landholdings dotted with big, noisy oil derricks. Such labor requires a solid, reliable, and sturdy pair of work boots, and Plainview can be seen wearing a pair of brown leather ones. They look suitably expensive, but they also look unsuitably modern. During a moment of rest, the camera shows the bottom of Plainview's boots, and they bear a waffle pattern, the kind found on early Nike running shoes. The latter is widely acknowledged as the originator of that kind of groove, which it pioneered in 1972, decades after the California oil boom. Dazed and Confused is one of the best teen movies of all time. A personal and casually realistic look at the night after the last day of school in 1976. Not a whole lot happens, just like what happens when real kids get together, both then and now. Early in the film, various characters cruise around town in their cars. During a scene shot from the point of view of one of these teens as they navigate traffic, a motorcyclist can be seen wearing a vest-type jacket adorned with the skull logo used by the punk band The Misfits. Though this skull drawing can be traced back to the 1930s, it's still likely an anachronism. Dazed and Confused takes place in 1976, a year before the band formed and 5 years before it publicly unveiled the skull logo. Pulp Fiction, possibly Quentin Tarantino's most beloved film, thoroughly earns the R rating bestowed upon it by the Motion Picture Association of America. The F-word is uttered more than 260 times. A character suffers a near-fatal drug overdose, and grisly violence is scattered throughout.
What? What? What ain't no country I ever heard of? They speak English and what?
Despite all that tawdry stuff, there's only one bit of nudity, and it was seemingly accidental. During a quiet moment when Butch hides out with his girlfriend Fabienne after refusing to throw a boxing match, he takes a shower. When he gets out, he grabs a towel while Fabienne brushes her teeth, but Willis doesn't hold the fabric high enough, thus revealing his manhood to moviegoers. Later, when Pulp Fiction aired on television, the towel was digitally stretched to cover the uncovered parts of Butch. The works of 19th century English author Jane Austen enjoyed a surge of popularity in the 1990s. Arguably the most successful 90s Austen-based project was 1995's Sense and Sensibility, which won cast member Emma Thompson a screenwriting Oscar and elevated the outside the UK fame of her co-stars Kate Winslet and Hugh Laurie. The intricately realized film also has a few modern touches, although one was clearly unintentional. With Colonel Brandon looking on, Mr. Palmer reluctantly holds an infant. The baby's outerwear is Regency appropriate, but its other garments are not. The little one wears a 20th century style disposable diaper, which certainly wasn't available in 1810. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Looper videos about your favorite movies are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.